My name is Corinne Wykes. I have type 2 diabetes and I've had that for over 30 years. It was found out by accident. I was having some tests done to get life insurance, and they found out that I got sugar in my urine, and then they did a blood test. And there was no care that I was aware of 30 years ago. There just wasn't. And if it was, it was just usually just your blood glucose. The thought of complications is what makes me want to look after my diabetes. I'm absolutely terrified of going blind, and I'm absolutely terrified of losing my feet.
I'm Professor Helen Calhoun. I'm Professor of Medical Informatics and Epidemiology here at the University of Edinburgh, and I lead a programme of research into diabetes and its complications. We have come a long way, I think, in addressing many of the complications of diabetes. Some of the research that we do here actually monitors the trends in complications over time. And we can see that cardiovascular disease rates have come down substantially in people with type 2 diabetes, and indeed in people with type 1 diabetes. Amputations aren't as common as they were previously. Rates of advanced eye disease are coming down. The new funding from NIHR and Diabetes UK is to fund research to explore why some people appear to be much more vulnerable to diabetes complications than others.
And I think research, you say, is an excellent way forward. And I think if I was to speak to a researcher about improving diabetes care, I think the first thing I would like to make sure is that people are informed. People knowing that there are complications and knowing what they can do about them.
We do know that actually, if you have very regular participation in healthcare, and if preventive therapies are introduced early, and if risk factors are managed carefully, and if people are fully supported in self-management of their diabetes, that actually you can live a long and good, healthy life free of complications. So it is important that we try to achieve that goal for everybody.